Okay, show of hands. Who would fly upside down in a jet?
But how does it do that?
Some planes can do crazy things, but one of the most extreme is the ability to fly at high speeds upside down. And not all planes can do this. Planes fly when air moving around the wing lifts the plane into the sky. With upside down flying, it gets a little more complicated. There are two main factors to consider when thinking about wings: the wing's design and the angle of attack. Normally, a wing has to be shaped very specifically to nudge the air over the top, allowing the air below to create lift. When a plane has to be able to fly both ways, the wing has to be shaped differently. On commercial planes, the wings are rounded in the front, bulged on top, and flat on the bottom. This helps air move faster over the top, which in turn makes the air less dense, helping the plane fly. Now, that's all fine if you're trying to just fly long distances at a steady speed, but flying upside down, that requires a whole different thought process when it comes to wing design. Planes built to fly upside down have to have uniquely shaped wings. Fighter jets, for example, have crazy thin wings, which allow them to go faster while producing more lift. Stunt planes have symmetrical wings, meaning they're curved on both the top and bottom to allow air to easily glide over the wings even when they're flying upside down. These planes are also a heck of a lot smaller and lighter than the massive planes that we fly across the country. The angle of attack, which I mentioned earlier, also affects these upside down movements. The angle of attack represents the measurement of how high the front of the wing is tilted. More tilt means more lift. When the pilot flies upside down, they have to understand their angle of attack, or the angle of the airplane's wing as it cuts through the air. Too little angle of attack, and there's not enough air below the wing to lift it up. So, if they push the nose into the sky, even while upside down, they can generate lift on a thin, symmetrical wing. Voila! Upside down flight, for a little while. Think about flying your hand out a car window. If you keep it level, it glides through the air. Tilt the leading edge up, and the air pushes the bottom of your hand, generating lift. That's the angle of attack. Fighter jets and stunt planes are a lot lighter and smaller than regular commercial planes, which is what gives them the ability to tilt their noses skyward, even while upside down, and get much higher angles of attack. This allows the planes to fly up, over, and, breathtakingly, upside down. It's safe to say that you'll probably never have to worry about a pilot taking you on a topsy-turvy joyride. That is, unless you're riding shotgun in a fighter jet. For more epic stories of innovation that shaped our future, check out theageofaerospace.com. I actually did ride in a fighter jet once. The whole experience was incredible. I definitely threw up everywhere. Learn all about my experience over here. Would you like to fly upside down? Let us know in the comments. Be sure to subscribe and come back here for more Seeker.